got coffee before we do anything. I had to get this very essential to start my day. So the next train is going to be at 1400. Yeah, that's the train we're going to get on. Good afternoon, good evening. Welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to show you guys what it's like in the city in Kamakura called Enoshima. It's like a little island. It's a lot of cool things to do. I just wanted to show you guys, you know, what it's like in Japan. You know, not a lot of people get to see this. Yeah. Alright, so starting off, I got the Prada monolith shoes. And then I got these pants from Yang Lee. Scripted trousers, and then the button-up shirt is Pineapple Monkey from Bottega Veneta. And then, you know, I got some accessories, always good to have that. And then I got a simple beanie, you know, always have to come through with the beanies.
Hey, with the situation going on with like the whole outbreak, what do you think about the whole thing in Enoshima now with the whole tourist?
There's too many people now, like you can see here. Like 3 months ago, if you walk through here, the same part, there's nobody. Like you can walk here, take photos, you won't get photo bombed. Yeah, it's like things are looking up now. So that's a good thing to see so many people actually.
Hey man, you can't go to a new city without just not thinking about the food. What can we get right here in Enoshima?
Yeah man, so like, this part of Kamakura is actually known for this fish. You'll see it a lot in like a lot of dishes here. It's called a siratsu, or white bait in English. It's like a little fish, like a small fish, but they put like a pile of it on like rice and like udon, so yeah.
That sounds good.
They don't normally cook it, it's kind of like raw. Yeah, so don't expect to find it cooked if you ever come here and eat it.
Yo, I'll be down to try new things.
Yeah, it's actually good. I mean, if you have to try it, you have to be open-minded to trying that stuff. I suggest it though.
Just took a little ferry.
Yeah, we're going to the island. It's actually like right over here. A lot of people go to that needle up here to see like the whole view of Kamakura. So that thing at the top of the island is called the Enoshima Needle. It's like a lookout point that you can see all of Kamakura, like the beach, shoreline and everything. So, it's a better day than it is now. It's kind of cloudy. You can get a better view of everything.
Look, there's people on the water. Say hi, people. Oh, they're waving. Hi. So friendly. Hi, fishermen. What fish you caught today? Right now, they're probably not going to be happy with us because we're probably disrupting the waves and everything. Is that a bird's nest?
That's a man cave.
Man cave? I don't see no hot Cheetos,
boy, snacks, if you don't get...
and drinks in there. That's my type of man cave.
Right now we just looking for a spot to do a little photo shoot. A lot of people here on this side of the rock.
There's hella people here.
Got me hippity hoppity mad. You know what? It's not that bad of a day. Like a little bit of the nature channel on my side here, you know? Look, they look like they're looking for oyster and clams and stuff. Yeah, we getting some nice footage going on. Some a little bit dangerous. We almost got swept up by the ocean there.
We almost got stuck in the riptide, bro. So these stairs are pretty steep.
Yep, I'm almost out of breath.
Ooh. Is this like the hiking part
of this island?
You have to pretty much walk a lot of stairs.
Man, what a view though. Oh, my thighs on fire.
Woo. You good? You guys good?
I need a glass of milk.
What milk, man? You need energy, bro.
Make your bone strong. What's that supposed to mean? Rishi food right here, boy. What's that? Komangwa sauce.
That's a happy booty.
It's like the shaved ice.
You look good though.
Yeah.
But we got more stuff to work off.
So, you guys can kind of tell how steep the stairs are. It goes all the way down here. So, you guys ever wonder why Japanese are so in shape? It's stuff like this that gets you, comes in handy to be in shape. Cause I'm breathing kind of hard too, low key.
Hey man, I'm a coffee lover. What can you say about coffee lovers, the best brand out there that you think?
Like the best in Japan?
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
And you say like, I would say that there's like two places in Tokyo I recommend. There's a place called Fuglin, and then there's another place called Deuce Coffee. Those two places are my recommendations. They're good.
So we're here at a Buddhist temple right now. So for the people that don't know what to do here, how does the tradition usually go?
There's many different ways to do this. I'm gonna keep my voice down because this is probably from a quiet area, but you know, most people, like, they get their yin. They normally get that 5 in because it's good luck. It has a little hole in the middle. They'll throw that in, and then they'll clap twice, and then they make a wish. And then when they're done with their wish, they bow and clap again. And then that's it, and they walk away.
So peaceful and quiet in here. Just wound up and saw this and thought, hey, why not get some...
trying to get some snacks. So if you guys don't know, so this is one location. I actually didn't know they had this here. It's called Taco Senbei. It's like a big cracker with either an octopus or a prawn. So the other location will be down the hill. We'll probably get to it later, but I think this is just a closer location for those who just don't want to walk all the way down, back down the island just to get this.
Yeah, waiting in line for our cracker. You hear the screams of octopus there? Hey, tell me what's going on here. We got birds. They look pretty friendly, don't they?
No, those things are big. Those things are seahawks, and they will steal your food if they get a chance. So, yeah, you see how close they fly around here? They'll just glide, glide, and glide away, and then boop, steal your food, man.
Yeah, Mr. Steal Your Snack.
Mr. Steal Your
Girl. Hey, let's go. Let's not hold up the line. And that's what attract the eagles. Who's that? What's on there? Such a Japanese thing, yeah?
Yeah, that's asahi. I don't know what that is. Yeah. Yeah, man, so this is it. I think they basically got an octopus and they put it on this presser. And the press like presses this octopus really, really tight that it turns into this. And then you can see how the octopus is inside of this senbei cracker. Yeah. But then it's pretty crispy too, so. It's actually good. It doesn't taste like the sea. It's actually like well balanced.
Hey, you better share.
You try this.
You better share. Oh, I appreciate you. I got this in my hand. I'm so afraid. Time to run, boys.
Man, but like, Japan has a lot to offer. There's a lot of nature in this whole island. Tokyo is pretty much like the most concentrated part of civilization. But the further out you go, it gets more scarce and more like countryside. And then you find gems like this every now and then when you go places. So it's good to just explore. Don't look at like Google Map and yeah, don't go to the tourist spots. And you'll find a lot of like special places. So yeah.
Yo, they talking about my feet? They said you got stinky feet? Hey, you into feet? Hey, is this normal here?
Oh no, man. I do not like feet. The little fishes, they get all the dead skin. They got it here in places too.
Just when you thought the sun goes down, you think people will go home. But it's actually getting livelier, right?
So, yeah, but this is the main alleyway of the island. If you walk more towards the beginning, it's the entrance. But yeah, this is that other taco senbei place. This is the most famous one right here.
Wow, look at that line.
This line is always long. Always long. People really come here to get it. Just to try it out.
Just to hear octopus scream.
Octopus be screaming, man. Screaming for your life.
Well, at least we saved them from the sea ox. Another thing caught my eye. What is it? More? Can you say it? Can you say it with me?
Shiratsu. Another one. So this is another dish. They made it in a croquet form, or like karaoke is what they say in Japanese. It's basically like, this is like a tempura or a fried potato. And then they add like that fish in it again, the white fish.
Yeah. What is that, shirasu ice cream? Is that a thing? Would you try it? Shirasu ice cream. I don't know. Then the Seahawk warning is no joke. It's still out here. We finally got what we want.
Oh.
Yo, taste test time.
Alright, we're gonna taste. We're gonna test this thing out too. Oh. Comes out pretty hot. I'm not gonna lie, I'm not sure why it's black, but I'm not gonna ask any questions, I'm just gonna eat it. But you can see the shirasu fish in here. You can see you kind of get the gist of what I mean by when you come here, a lot of dishes have this in it, so.
It's good.
I think it legit tastes like a potato.
Oh yeah, give me some.
Like a fry.
Where's some? Thank you. It's a karaoke. Alright. So since it got shirasu in it, would you call this cake by the ocean? No? That's me?
Good morning, I'm just smoking while I ride. Playing Illmatic, one love, New York state of mind. Thirsty.